What is going on, guys? Welcome to a brand new video. Welcome back to the channel. It's Dev. We're here. The boys. The season 2 finale. We're almost on to season 3, which I'm really excited for because I've heard a lot of praise for season 3. I have, and I'm just ready to get to season 4 when it's live and you know, I could be there when it's live and that'll be a fun time. But first, we got to get through this shit and shit popped off last episode. Before we get to last episode, congratulations to Brazil. You know, a lot of shit in the world right now is, you know, very reminiscent of what, you know, could happen in the boys. You got things like Kanye West with his talking points and his rhetoric. You know, I'm a freedom of speech advocate, but Jesus Christ. Yeah, I don't want to get too much into it. It's just, it's really cringe, and I still love Kanye's music. I'm sorry, I'm going to listen to I Wonder. It's a just great song. I'm sorry, it's not my problem. So, that shit's going on. Congratulations to Brazil. Lula da Silva. Congratulations. That's good. Under aggressive far right wing you know, politics over there in Brazil. So luckily, hopefully it's okay. You know what I mean? Like, obviously he had that shit back in what, like, what was that, like 2003? He had that, you know, corruption scandal. But democracy, it's a wonderful thing. And obviously you wouldn't want to be under far right you know, extremists like Bolsonaro. But nonetheless, sorry to get into real-world politics. I know some people come to YouTube or whatever to stray away from that stuff. But, you know, it kind of relates to what's going on here. Because we had hearings last episode where a bunch of people had their heads blown off. And who knows who the fuck that could be. Who knows what in, like, what could happen. Like, it was very crazy. And shit's about to change. Shit is about to change. And then, you know, Lamplighter's dead. Damn. Unfortunate. He burned himself alive. And, yeah. We met, Billy's dad. Forgot his name. But Billy's father. Who is a not great guy. But hey. To each their own. You know what I mean? I am sick, by the way, just to let y'all know. But I'm chilling. Alright, I'm chilling. I might be coughing here and there, but other than that, we're having a good time. Yeah, let's get into the boys' season 2 finale, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get into it in 3, 2, 1. Uh-oh. How to survive
a supervillain on your school campus. You hear the calls of distress, you witness a violent display of superpowers.
The president doesn't like you.
Oh.
He used the word standoffish. And two, he's decided. He's declaring a national emergency, bypassing the FDA, and authorizing Compound V for use by law enforcement and...
Doctor, are you fucking...
A tape of me fucking my kid's nanny at her daughter's quinceañera? Release it, please. I'm begging you. A plum gig at Fox and this shithole in my rear view sounds...
True! That's great!
The RPG releases an electromagnetic pulse on impact. Should cut through Stonefront's plasma balls.
Oh, sure.
They're going full.
That's Stonefront. Thanks to Starlight, we know that Noir needs any fucking trainer. How about a trainer?
Got enough epinephrine here to blow up that motherfucker's heart.
Hey. Oh my god!
He said he lives under a pawn shop and he's flat butch.
Hey, let her in.
Help me!
Oh.
I can't exactly be.
Oh shit. A fresco.
Can I?
Would you like a fresco?
Fresco?
No, thank you. Awful stuff.
Awful stuff.
You're okay.
I
got you.
Oh, man. That was kind of fire, though.
Hey, I saved your life, asshole. Now you're coming after us?
No, actually. Ah.
But even now, bitch.
Shit. Is this true?
Everything makes a little more sense now, doesn't it?
Where did you get this?
I didn't get it, okay? I was never here. Got that shit on your own, yeah?
But why are you doing this?
Because I want back in. So I need her gone.
Ah.
Fucking nuts, bitch.
Yeah! I'm all for A-Train now, baby. Oh. A-Train. I love it. We can have our differences, and I can disagree with certain things, but when it comes to Nazis, fuck them.
Angry people want Compound V. Compound V raises our stock price. Look.
Guess what? Everything's done for money.
We play with the cards we're dealt. It's not ruthless. It's prices per share. That's all.
Capitalism!
Because that bitch above you.
Of course she does. But it's not about me. I can't lash out like some raging entitled maniac. That's a white man's luxury.
Oh!
She's great. We talked earlier, and she's really great. You're great.
All right, easy, Tiger. I guess you got fuck all.
No witnesses, but we definitely found fuck all. I'm not sure I'm using that term properly, but
he's not.
All right, that's okay. You'll get it. I know what. Imagine, sometimes it helps to imagine someone you hate.
I don't really hate anyone.
Well, that is very sweet, Ryan. But it's not something we can afford.
Oh.
Attack. We are?
Bad guys want to hurt us just because of what we look like.
Oh, my God.
They want to wipe us from this earth just because of the color of our skin.
Oh, God.
Really?
It's called white genocide.
Oh, God.
And we're going to need people like you to protect our kind.
Literally. Oh, God.
So let's try again.
Nazi. Imagine ideology.
Holy shit.
This broke.
Oh shit! Literally with. Oh my God!
Already, an intense international outcry has emerged.
I can't believe I actually have to say this day and age, but Nazis are bad.
Nazi stormfront, Hitler star. Run her over with a car.
It's catchy.
I love it. I love it.
Take my car. Get them both to Mallory. Get them both safe.
No, that's not part of the plan.
The plan just changed. And you're the only one I trust.
Oh, fuck.
A deal that when I got Ryan, that I would call Vought, they were going to come and take him away, and that you'd never fucking see him again.
That's what it...
Where's my son? Where is my son?
I'm not leaving here without you. I don't care.
Who's gonna sell
Holy me shit, dude.
Bitch! I'm assuming it's you who sent all those lies to the press.
They're not lies.
People love what I have to say. They believe in it. They just don't like the word Nazi. That's all.
Are you right? You right? Yeah?
She says the truth is, she's gonna stick her boot up your Nazi kitty.
Oh shit! Oh yeah! Kick it! Oh, fuck!
Annie! Oh, no, Brigitte! This is the cards, our only chance!
Oh, Kimiko! Yeah!
Hey, Kraut.
Move! Oh, she's good, yes! Kick that Nazi bitch's ass!
Girls do get it done.
Oh, God damn it. Oh my God.
Come here, Ryan.
How about your life?
You're not like her, Ryan. You belong with us.
Stay the fuck away from my son.
We love you, Ryan.
Ah! It's not gonna do anything.
You fucking bitch.
Fuck.
Stop.
Ryan, come on. Access it. Come on, Ryan. Come on, Ryan. Yes! Don't. Oh my God.
I'm sorry, Mom.
Oh no.
Hold on.
You're gonna let them go.
And if I don't?
Don't die with them. I know that you and Maeve are two of the best, most loyal friends that I could ever have. We are your heroes. We are here to serve and protect you. Stormfront's violation of that special relationship.
That was.
That's right now.
Wait, does that mean?
I just spoke to Stan Edgar. You're back in.
Fuck yes!
What?
Yeah! Yeah! A-Train is back, baby!
A-Train is back, baby.
All right.
Whew. Finally.
Yeah. I'm back too, right? Right? I'm anti-Nazi.
I'm sorry.
I'm anti-Nazi. You just said fuck him when he was.
And you fucking promised.
I'm sorry, Deep, but you are acting like a toxic personality. I think you should be.
Oh, God.
Remember what I told you.
Don't be a cunt.
The book's funding for a team that can keep tabs on the soups. If you're interested.
God only knows.
We have enough dirt to ruin a dozen soups.
Be a death blow for Stan Edgar. That is, of course, if you're open to expediting the church's tax-exempt status.
Small price to pay.
My office set up here.
You.
This time I stand on my own 2 feet.
They know you're here?
They haven't told me yet.
When can you start?
Citizens for Corporate Oversight. Newman fights for everyone. Resist VOT. A lot to talk about, honestly. I have a lot to say. There's a lot of... political things in there, just life, like how just society is in general. Obviously, you have what's going on within the story. Yes, that's a big part, but I just like the parallels to just society in general. You know what I mean? I'm a nerd for that. I'm a geek for that. So, honestly, like, I'm here for it. I appreciate it. And, you know what I mean? It's interesting. A lot of things, though. Definitely. A lot of things. Obviously, Stormfront done. Done with. The main thing of this season was Nazis. Not Nazis, but, like, just, you know, obviously, everything with Stormfront and her ideology. You had Huey. You had all this shit with Vought. And, you know, and then Becca and Butch, which was incredibly sad. I had a feeling she was gonna die, but in the way she died by her own son is just, that's tough. Poor kid, and I truly hope he doesn't grow up to, you know, turn into Homelander, because that would suck. It really would. But Homelander, he's gonna snap. He's gonna do something, and it's not gonna be good. I mean, he's just standing up there. I didn't know what he was standing on. It was it the what a statue of, I didn't see what it was, but he was jerking off on something. He gets off on himself. He loves himself so much. It's kind of weird. But Anthony Starr is just insane. He's so good. One of the best actors right now. His character is incredibly evil. There's a part of you which can sympathize with, but he is just an evil. He's evil. But the performance is just, it's so well done. And this was by far my favorite episode. This was probably the most I've, like, just enjoyed an episode front to back. Like, holy goddamn shit. I love the girl power moment. You know, it wasn't, like, in your face. Like, it makes sense. Like, all these, they're all badass. And it works. They're kicking the shit out of a Nazi. And it's so creepy, too. When she was all burnt up and she just started speaking German. Why did she start speaking German? Maybe it was because her brain functions were just all low, to the max. So it was only whatever language she originated. Maybe it was that. I don't know, but creepy. I'm a person who despises Nazis. I hate Nazis. Like, obviously, you can joke about it. Like, obviously, all types of humor. You can make humor about all sorts of things. About anybody. But you don't have to make it offensive and a stereotype. You know what I mean? Like, you could say, like, I find my gay friend annoying because of their taste in men or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, something like that. Like, that's a good joke. It's not a stereotype. It's something that you could relate to. It's like, hey, sorry, my friend just has a shitty taste in men or whatever it may be. You know what I mean? Like, you could do that or anything. And yeah, it's just Nazis, I hate them. I hate fucking Nazis, dude. Like, and it's just, it blows my mind that people unironically will think this way. Like, they believe in the white genocide theory and, you know, the 13 words and just all these Nazi beliefs that white people are oppressed and, you know, that's the truth. And everybody knows the truth, they just don't want to know it yet. Like, it's bullshit. It's bullshit. You know what I mean? Like, you're a crazy person. You have no friends. You weren't loved as a child. You were brought into this. You know? It's all just because you're a loser piece of shit. You know what I mean? Like, sorry. Not my problem. There's no defense you can have for Nazis. You can come, like, I'm... Like, there could be people, I'm not a big fan of Nazis, but... Like, no. No. Not at all, buddy. Nope. Not even gonna listen to what you have to say. And it's crazy because in society today, it is very easy to go down that alt-right pipeline like that. It is probably as terrifying as ever. Because I remember when I was like, I don't know, 10, 11, 12, you know, watching YouTube, and you would watch maybe, I don't know, like I would watch some sort of like end of the world video. You know what I mean? Like end of the world prophecy 2012 or whatever. You know what I mean? Back in those days. And it would start with that, and it would be a religious kind of content, the rapture, shit like that. And I would watch it. And then it would dive into Hollywood Satanism. And then it would start with that, and it would just start blaming these people. And then it would lead into the Jews, and then leading in that the Jews own everything and all sorts. Like, you know where I'm going. And then it's just, you know, pure blood, and white people are the superior race. You know, it's sickening. There's another thing that Nazis like to talk about is like the Great Hanging or like something like that, where it's everybody besides white people, pure white, blue-eyed, you know, people, not Jews, like just straight European descent, and that's it. And everybody else, no matter who you are, will get hung. It's disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting. And I know some people don't want to hear about me going into this rant because they just want to talk about the show, but like, it's just something I got to point out, you know what I mean? The show is blatantly putting it there in your eyes, and there will be people who unironically are be like, I like Stormfront. I think she's a good character. Or I actually think Homelander's a great character. He's a really good guy. I can empathize with him. Like, yo, those people might have problems. If you do it as a joke or whatever and just a shitpost, like, I get it. Shitposting is different. Some people may not think it is, but there's an art behind shitposting. It's got to be done very well. Like, especially on TikTok or something, you got to have, like, a very unique and, like, a funny, goofy sound with a bunch of random pictures. And it could not mean anything, but it could be taken on a bad side. But it's just a joke. It's a shitpost. So, there's two different sides, but, like, I just, it makes me uncomfortable. Just the term Nazis and what Nazis believe, just always, like, even since a kid, just always made me uncomfortable. And then going back to those conspiracy theories and, like, that shit I saw when I was a kid going down that alt-right pipeline, like, it terrified me. But I low-key almost fell into it. Not like full Nazi shit, but like I'm like the Hollywood satanic shit like that. And then I let it go because it didn't affect me in my life. And then once I grew up more, and maybe over the last 2 years, ever since the pandemic started, I just kind of educated myself more. And I was like, oh, they're being anti-Semitic. It all leads back to here. This shit can date back to blood libel and God knows how long ago with Jewish people. And yeah, it's just, it always made me uncomfortable. So I just, anytime I hear about anybody who's a Nazi, it's just like, I don't want them here. They just shouldn't be here. And yeah, it's disturbing. And I love Stormfront getting her ass kicked. It was great by Maeve. Maeve coming in was awesome. But we leave off with a victory. Bittersweet, I should say. Sure, Stormfront's dead. Yay, the Nazis out of here. Good, good thing. But you know what holds everything all together in the society we need? Like Edgar stated it himself. He was like, money. He's doing all this because of the stock market and just money, profit. capitalism is the main ingredient of society. The things we do, the decisions we make as in a government, is for the betterment of capitalism and profit gain for all these big corporations. So I see lobbyists all over the place in the government. You know, got Elon Musk doing what he's doing. Him taking over Twitter. Shit like that. I bet we're going to have... What if we have like an Elon Musk... I wonder if we're going to have an Elon Musk type character in season 3. If not season 4. But you got to have like... I know Edgar is that kind of like just, you know, businessman, just capitalist, bourgeoisie, just piece of shit. People like that is why we say eat the rich. You know what I mean? People talk about liberal snowflakes. I'm not a liberal. I hate liberals with a passion. Don't get me wrong. And that's what I could see with Victoria. I bet she could be... They're going to start making fun of the left now. The liberal side. Is she truly going to get anything done? Or is she just going to kill people? I mean, she has these powers now. Maybe did she already have them before? Or did she get them because of Compound V? Did she get a sample of Compound V before... Or like a dose of Compound V before they discontinued it. Which is a good thing. Good thing they did that. Good. Good. Because Stormfront definitely would have got a group on her side. And they would have got done with some shit. But regardless. Out to Homelander. He can do what he wants. A-Train's back. He's back in the groove. Good to see him back. The Deep's probably going to try and do something. I mean, the Fresca guy. I don't remember his name. But... He's done. Like, holy shit. Crazy. I love the touch with the Church of the Collective, too. It's also a good touch on society as well with churches. And he mentioned about getting being tax-exempt. And obviously, Democrats and the even the left. Leftists, per se. Liberals and the left, or liberals and leftists are not the same. Some tend to think they are. They are not. Okay? Leftists are fairly anti-capitalist. Liberals are still very, very capitalist. They fight for the same things that the Republican Party does. But the Republican Party has different methods of executing capitalism. Two different, very different ways. But still fighting for that same goal. But... I'm curious to see what this Victoria chick does. Is she going to be your typical just, you know, Democrat running for Congress who's still going to advocate for progressive, like, policy? It's probably not going to get through. It never gets through. It never does. So we'll see if any of that happens. Butcher, he will probably be working with Mallory. I could see that. Huey, though, working with... Victoria in her campaign. That's gonna be fun. I'm excited to see more of a political Huey. And with this next season 3, it's probably gonna get into a lot of election stuff, and we're gonna see a lot of different sides take form. We're gonna see probably a lot of the people who believe in neo-Nazis and that ideology. You're gonna see a lot of, you know, obviously. I bet we'll have, you know, funny takes on leftists and activists. You know, there's a lot of activists out there, but they're just doing it like performance art. It's just performance art for them. It's how a lot of activists are nowadays. They'll post it on social media, they'll say all this stuff, but when it really boils down to when it matters, nah, they won't. They'll say, and that's kind of the Democratic Party in 2022, or just forever, I should say. They've never really, they've fought for progressive values and policy, and some have passed, yes, but most of the time that shit ain't gonna get done. $15 an hour federally, when is that gonna happen? Marijuana, federally, why can't we get it passed? What is taking forever? MM's with his wife. Finally. Good. Frenchie and Kamiko, great. Ah, I love it. It makes me so happy. It makes me happy. I love it. I'm happy. I'm happy. And I'm sad for Butch, though. He lost his girl, and he's still going to probably destroy Vi. And he's going to want to. And I'm excited to see Soldier Boy. Yes, I know about Soldier Boy. I don't know anything about his character. I just know the actor, and that his name is Soldier Boy. And I've seen memes, but I've tried to avoid them at all cost. I know there is an episode called Herogasm, and that it's one of the greatest episodes ever. I don't know what happens, but I just know it's great. So, yeah. I'm excited to see what happens in Season 3, though. We'll see you next Monday, ladies and gentlemen. And I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction. If you did, please like, favorite, subscribe. Hit the notification bell for daily videos every single day. Follow me on Twitter, Twitch, TikTok, and Instagram. And all the social medias down in the description below. And we'll catch you for another video. Goodbye!